In most of the stories, when characters face a problem, they either overcome it or they run away from it. But what if, even though they can't overcome that problem, they refuse to run away? In that case, ladies and gentlemen, we get characters like Natsuki Subaru and Okabe Rintaro, or Rintaro Okabe according to weeb rules. Most of the likable characters can be put on this scale that ranges from normal relatable dude type of characters to hyper competent individuals. We like normal relatable dude type characters because even though they aren't competent enough, they try, and hence we feel sympathetic towards them. And we like hyper competent individuals because they are badass. While normal relatable dude is what we ourselves are, hyper competent individual is what we fantasize to be, and hence we like them. And of course, there are characters who are mixture of both these properties, or like many stories, it can be about a character going through this chat formation from being a normal relatable dude to hyper competent individual. Yeah, your power fantasy. And the reason I bring this up is because at the start of their journeys, at the start of their stories, Subaru and Okabe are different. Subaru's character leans heavily towards normal relatable dude. He couldn't get shit done in season 1, and ReZero season 2 did a great job showing his life before reincarnation. We now know that he was depressed and failing at life even before Truck-kun cursed him. While Okabe was a hyper competent individual, I mean, yeah, he was socially awkward, but dude fucking invented time machine. The difference in their starting point give both of the characters different perks. Okabe is very likable character because he's competent, and many people, although don't like Subaru because he has been depressed boy from the start and he isn't some overpowered isekai protagonist, but that gives layers to Subaru's journey. His journey isn't only about saving the girls, it's also about overcoming his lack of self-respect. So clearly, these two characters were very different before the main antagonistic forces kicked in the story. But when it did, they had a similar journey. They tried and tried and tried. They failed and failed and failed. They got depressed and depressed and depressed. Yes, Okabe had built a time machine, but against the antagonistic forces of the story, he became underpowered. He, for the most part of the story, was a normal, relatable dude type of character, even though he invented the time machine. Since Okabe's journey is now over, since the anime is finished, you might think that he has now become the character who overcomes the problem he faces. And while, yeah, he did overcome the problem, by that logic, you can put every character from a story that has a happy ending in this category. It's not about they overcome this problem at the end of the story. It's about what the story focuses the most on their character journey. This similar yet somehow different journey of these two characters are unique because whenever there's a character like them in a story who tries but doesn't succeed, they are usually side characters like Rock Lee from Naruto. So we don't really focus on their journey that much, but fortunately Okabe and Subaru are the main guys. The whole story is about their journey. And this is really important for the entertainment culture, because most of the heroes we get either overcome a problem by throwing hands, or even when they face a crisis, they do it for a small time and they overcome it with a smile on their faces. But that doesn't work in real life, does it? We don't just overcome a problem once and we have a happy life ever after. We have to face some kind of problems no matter what we do in life. And most of the people can't quit either. Quitting is hard. But what most people do is just hang in there. Look, I know all of us wanted an Omnitrix and become a hero. All of us screamed in our classes wishing to turn into Super Saiyans. But I'm sorry that it didn't happen. So yeah, you can't be a superhero in real life. But what you can do is maybe take care of your family, maybe give yourself a life that you deserve. Sending a single message on Discord to an online friend may help him tremendously, you never know. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the realistic hero's journey. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Like the video if you liked the video. Dislike the video if you disliked the video. Share the video if you feel extra good today. And that will be all. See you.